Savages has always remained to be one of my favorite movies, because it can only be a film. It cannot be a novel, it cannot be a play, it can only be a film. And the genesis of that film is also very unusual. It came about because James stumbled on an old colonial mansion in upstate New York, in a place called, a tiny place called Scarborough, which is near Tarrytown. He stumbled across this ancient, old American colonial mansion, the center part of which is dates back to 17-something, really quite a long way. And not only was it still standing in reasonably good condition, but it was full of all sorts of props of the 20s, cutlery and clothes and costumes and little dolls, all sorts of junk. And when they discovered that, he decided to write a script around, which was based on this house and was built around, it was built around the house. And that also makes it fairly unique. And then he engaged two script writers, who were James Trowe and Michael Moriarty. Anyway, the names we'll have to look up. But there were two separate script writers who wrote different portions of that movie, which had a very simple basic story. It's the story of civilization told in one day. There's these savages, which you see in the jungle, wearing mud masks, like they were wearing, I believe it's made based on the people of the tribe in New Guinea. And they wear these mud masks, and you discover them in the jungle doing their rituals and dancing around. And then they discover this, the house, to which they are led by the flight of a croquet ball, which arrives mysteriously in the jungle. It says where spherical objects, perfectly spherical objects were unknown, something like that. And then they become civilized, they doff their masks and they put on dinner jackets and they give a dinner party. Every Merchant Ivory film has a dinner party in it, almost everyone. And then things begin to go wrong, they become a bit decadent, there's a lot of talk about things going wrong generally in the world. And there's this frenetic croquet match at the end, and then they all go back and separately and severally into the jungle. That's the story. And it's all filmed in a light-hearted manner. It's not meant to be heavily symbolic. Some critics later on, after it was first shown, almost stubbornly refused to understand that film. They says, oh, this heavy symbolism. There isn't any heavy symbol. It's absolute nonsense. It's a story which you can follow very easily. It's not highbrow in any way at all. But they sort of said this is all symbolic stuff. And a lot of people didn't understand it. Because you couldn't say, what is this film about? Now, if you say it's about civilization in taking place in the course of one day, then of course it sounds heavily symbolic. So that doesn't describe it properly. And how do you describe it? Sometimes people fail to get the point because they can't just relax and sit by and watch the damn thing. I was in a festival jury once I think it was in Poland, and there was a fellow cameraman, an English cameraman, with me, and they showed a Slovenian Slovakian I think television film, which ends in an unexplained act of levitation. But it's a very funny comedy, and it went very, very well down very well with the audience there. But this friend of mine, I think it was Ronnie Taylor, was on the jury with me, and he came out absolutely furious, and he said, what is that all about? Tell me, what is this about? And I said, well, isn't it obvious what it's about? And he said, well, what about this levitation thing? I said, well, you know, you don't have to explain everything. But I think Savages very mysteriously fell into a certain sort of vacuum hole between explainable subjects, and it was never shown on television. They offered it to, they offered Savages to the BBC, and at that time I think Channel 4 hadn't started. But it was offered to television, and it was turned down, and it was turned down in America, and in England it was turned down again after 20 years. Well, when you consider all the rubbish that they do show quite happily on television, that is a bit extraordinary, because it's a remarkable film. and have all these film clubs explained by Derek Malcolm and God knows who. And it was never expected, because never accepted for television.